Happy Friday and welcome back to the Creative Studio here at Spellbinders. I am Kim Kesty and excited as always to be here, and I've got something really fun to share with you today, and it's going to kind of appeal to you shopping addicts, you shopaholics. Come on, admit it. If you're one, raise your hand. And if you are watching us on YouTube, consider liking and sharing and subscribing and all that fun things. Okay, get the business part over with. Let's take a look at the new collection that I'm going to be featuring today. It is called Add to Cart, and it's actually by one of our licensed designers. Her name is Becky Roberts. And if those of you who are not familiar with Becky, her little channel is called Inking Idaho, and you can find her there on Instagram and Facebook and all the good things, and she has an amazing blog. She's not only a great paper crafter, she also does other really fun crafts too. So check out Becky Roberts. But Becky had this idea. She's really a big fan of shopping carts, and she has been since she was just a little girl. So when she got the opportunity to do a shopping cart die with us here at Spellbinders, we were all mutually super excited. So here's a basic die of the shopping cart, and it is adorable as is, and you will see that as I play with it today. But we thought, you know what, shopping carts are not typically empty, so Becky also came up with some really cute ideas for the holidays, and I just imagine she'll be launching more of these in the future. But here's a darling one with a Christmas tree and some packages and bows. You can kind of see how this comes to life. You'll see lots and lots and lots of different ideas, again, on our blog here at Spellbinders or on Becky's blog. So there's lots of projects out there right now. This launched a few weeks ago, so it's definitely out in the social media universe. So here's a little party add-on. So we've got some cute banners, which are darling on the cart. You've got the little high heel shoe, which I love, the little wine bottle and balloons and all the party things. And then the last one is these really cute shopping bags. And I'm actually going to show a project that Becky made featuring these shopping bags in the cart because, hey, it's all about, you know, getting all the shopping done. And then this is really a fun kind of add-on too. Speaking of the collection name, by the way, did I already say this? It's Add to Cart. So it's just fun to get those little add-ons. So this stamp set is great to match, mix and match with all the different dies. You've got kind of your little, not really seasonal stamps here, but ones you can use throughout the year. So all your thanks and sale. And I love this one because I bought it on sale. I actually made money. Yes, I love how Becky thinks. So super cute there. So let me show you one card that Becky created before I start my crafting. And again, this features not only the shopping cart, but also the cute little shopping bags. So you just kind of cut these guys out twice and fold them, and they become super cute and dimensional. Look, she got the little tissue paper in there. So what you're going to see right now as you see the shopping cart come to life, ooh, good angle, right, is that it's 3D. It's got this really great 3D element. So you can put all the little items in here. And to make it super flexible and super versatile, let me share with you that she's actually created the die so you've got two different depths. So you can make the shopping cart a little thinner in depth, and that's by using this die, or you can make it a little bit deeper. So you can fit more things in the cart if it's a little deeper. So, so fun. Let me show you just a cart also that is just pretty basic. This is actually cut so cutely out of our mirror paper. So this is our mirror silver. And this cart is created with a little bit deeper sections here. So this is deeper than the one I'm going to create, which I'll show you in a minute. And also, this time Becky did not put the little bottom piece on the die, which is right here. Because this is just a decorative element on a card, it doesn't really need to hold anything. I am adding the bottom piece to my project today because I wanted to hold something, which I will show you as we go along. And so, first things first, some die cutting. You want to go ahead and cut out two sides of your shopping cart so it can hold all the things. And then you've got two depths of shopping cart, like I just discussed. You've got your thicker side that matches the thicker bottom, of course, and then your slimmer side and your slimmer bottom. So I chose to do the slimmer side right here. So we're going to go ahead and get my right piece here. It's pre-scored, so I folded it a little bit, and you just want to add a little bit of glue here, or you can use sticky tape, white liner tape, whatever you need to do. And then you're just going to add it to the side of the cart here. Keep your glue going here. And then, of course, you're going to add glue to the other side, and you're going to add all the pieces to your shopping cart. And then when you cut the second piece, I should have not glued this so I could show you, but you also see little score lines on here, and I don't know if I can come in really close. Well, I guess you can see them pretty good there. You're gonna wanna just trim this little guy down to do the front end of your shopping cart. So again, you can use those lines right there, and you would just trim it a little bit shorter to do the other side of your shopping cart. And then this guy, once these are all dry, your bottom part simply has these little tabs, which also have little score lines. So super easy. This becomes the bottom of your cart. And those tabs are there just to help you adhere it to the inside of your cart. So this little guy just drops right in here. So it's a little fiddly, but not bad. And then you have this super cute 3D shopping cart, which I'm going to bring mine in. And I've already got mine kind of decked out a little bit. And guess what inspired my shopping cart, you guys? Seriously, this is so much fun. So first, let me flip it up. You can see the bottom. See where I've got the little tabs tucked in? It's all glued. Again, the little end is glued in here, and the taller side is glued in here. And then after that, it's really just about these little fun pieces. You've got the bottom of your shopping cart, and of course your shopping cart wheels. This is an extra handle, which you can decorate, sort of like Becky did with this one. You can add, you know, your cute little accent pieces. But because I was going for, you know, the Target look, I just cut mine out of a brush silver, so it's not as shiny as this guy, but kind of more, you know, akin to our one of our favorite shopping stores. And then guess what? I just used a little wheel and cut my little logo there. Okay, I'm sorry. I crack myself up sometimes. Love it. Thought it was so much fun. And again, I didn't want to necessarily do my card project holiday or anything, so I just brought in some kind of simple backdrops here. I've got our amazing slimline die here. This is our fun diagonal stripes going on. So I just embossed the slimline part right down the middle in our adorable paper here. And I've got a little black binding or a little matting here going on the other side, just because I thought, well, it's got kind of the look of the black and white. Maybe I'm channeling the dollar spot here. I don't know. Too much fun. Just adding a little bit of glue. I'm just going to put this, you could pop it up, but I'm just kind of putting mine directly on my card base here. And by the way, I'm going to bring back in Becky's card real quick with a stamp, because I think this little accent is so cute. Look at her little stamp. She's got these little marks down here for like your little trail for your shopping cart to be like, hey, stop, check this out. I actually thought she hand drew this first, and then I realized it's part of the stamp set. That's so clever. So anyway, stamp set is super fun. We've got our fun little cart going on here. And now I've got a sentiment, which of course does come from the stamp set also. It's called It's an Add to Cart Kind of Day. And I thought this would be super fun just for a more generic gift card type of thing. And guess what fits in this cart? This is where this is all happening right here. You know it. One of these fun little gift cards. So look, fits in there just perfect. I've got the bottom so it doesn't fall out. Then I thought I would kind of just use this banner to help keep the gift card in place. This little foam square won't damage the gift card, but I'm gonna kind of use it to hold it in place. So I'm gonna maybe put it right around here on my card front. So then that'll just help the card, you know, from falling out. And this is a top fold card, so it's kind of fun that you could actually have it, you know, once you give it as a gift. Super cute to set on someone's little shelf or tabletop or desk space or whatever. So cute. So, absolutely love this. I had so much fun with it. Oh, I was going to share one other thing. I was debating about this guy. I think I might add a few of these, though. One of the little die sets, the little Christmas tree, has this cute little star inside. So I actually just cut them out of a little bit of glitter paper. I'm going to sprinkle just a couple around before I let you go real quick. Maybe just three, right? For just a little sparkly accent. I mean, this could be for the holidays, but it could absolutely be for just any kind of birthday or just pick-me-up day or whatever. There. Now I feel like it's done with the cute little shiny stars. So cute. So we'll definitely get this project up on the blog so you can kind of see step by step. I absolutely know you will love Becky Roberts' whole collection, again called Add to Cart, which you can find, of course, at spellbinderspaperarts.com. Check it out, along with a bunch of other new things we just loaded up for the holidays too. So definitely check it out. Check out what's new. Hit the what's new button, shop around, and you can do your part and add to cart, right? Have a great weekend crafting, and we'll see you next time.